Hey guys, so today you and I are going to talk about having work dumped on you and your manager trying to get you fired. So let's get into it. So the question in question was basically, Frederick, I suspect that my manager is trying to get me to quit, but by giving me a lot of work and a lot of boring work, what should I do? And the short answer is take a stroll through the office, have some coffee, sit down in due time at your computer, watch some educational videos related to programming on YouTube or something like that, maybe this channel, who knows, and then just just relax and slowly start addressing the issues that you have been given. Let me explain. So why I'm suggesting this is basically because now you are in a very, very interesting situation. Because if they're trying to get you to quit, it is most likely because of a reason. Because if they are not firing you, then there's an agenda here. And that agenda is very likely that they don't want to pay you severance pay or some other, I don't know where you are from. There are usually different rules. If you quit, you are not entitled to compensation or things like that. But if they fire you, they have to. There's a bunch of laws depending on your region, right? So I'm guessing because they're not firing you, then they want to save some sort of money or something like that is going on, right? So that basically means that if they're treating you as shit, then you have pretty much no motivation to give them anything back. Nothing meaningful, at least. The thing that I suggest that you do here is that you basically do what I'm saying. Like, you start thinking about yourself. Like, because if they are trying to get you to quit, or if they're pushing in a fashion where, like, they're not being transparent, or they're doing something that it feels fishy, and they don't want to tell you about it, or like they're not acting in good faith. If they're not acting in good faith, then fuck them. Like, really, just fuck them. Go for yourself in that regard, because they have clearly communicated, they have clearly shown that they're not interested in a healthy relationship or a healthy dialogue regarding this issue, then why should you? So do that, but also start preparing, because if you start slowing down, or if you things of this nature, like either that you're going to force their hand at some point, because unless there's some magical reason why they can't fire you, they're going to get, you know, at some point they're going to have to. And if they can't ever, then like, why do you even come into the office and figure out what the bare minimum you can do is, and then just kind of live with it if you are happy living in that sort of environment? Because I can imagine that, well, at least for me, that would be a very toxic environment to be in, but I can understand that some people would bear something like that because they're basically off the hook. There's no pressure anymore to perform. Some people like to think like that. But what I suggest you do is that you start looking for other options, unless, as I said, you're fine where you are and you don't really care about that environment. So have a look at your options. You are a software developer, my friend. And unless the world is literally ending, the IT industry is going under, or like we're going into a massive recession, you're going to find another job. You are in very, very high demand. And if you're unhappy where you are, it shouldn't be much of a struggle for you to get a different occupation, or like not a different occupation, but get a job somewhere else. So what I want you to take away from this is that if you suspect that your manager is trying to get you to quit because they're giving you shit tasks or like a lot of extra work or stuff like that, then just go back to the bare bone requirements of what you need to do in order to do do your job. And trust me when I say this, you can win this fight much quicker than they can, because even if they give you a mountain of work, nobody has ever stated how fast you need to deliver on this work. You can sit there and like you play with your belly button all day and maybe write a few lines of code. No, there's no measurement for what dictates if you're incompetent or not. So And if they're not trying, if they're not actually firing you and they want you to quit, then you, the ball is in your corner. You are in the power position in this situation because of circumstances. They're not firing you because if they, if you, if they had the power position, they would just fire you. Be mindful though, because it might go to the point where they actually do have to go in and fire you and they're just willing to cut you loose. So make sure that you at least have your CV up to date and that you are prepared for the fact that you might need to find another job, which shouldn't be much of a struggle for you. But until then, sit back and just relax. There's no pressure on you. They're just trying to make it feel like there's pressure on you. Have a great day.